said no thanks. What else you got?
Edison, New Jersey. The day before arrival. Zach Taylor is stood in an antique shop in the center of town. He had come to buy a gift for his mother's birthday, but now finds himself facing off with a rather persistent elderly shop owner.
Perhaps if you saw it.
The keeper reaches under the counter, taking out a small black case, opening it to reveal a gold-pressed coin sitting in the middle of a cushioned red velvet lining.
No, man, she doesn't want some stupid collectible coin. Now, if you ain't got anything else, I'm...
He stops as his eyes meet the coin.
Then again...
He picks it up, not taking his eyes from it.
Maybe she'd like this one.
I told you, you only needed to see it.
How much?
We have a sale on today. $1.
What? Get out of here. How much, really?
$1, and it's yours.
Really? All right, here.
He pays the man and soon leaves the store. It would be hours before he would even take his eyes off of it. Now, inside the Mastodon Zord.
Oh, hell.
What?
I just remembered I didn't get my mom another present. Her birthday is tomorrow.
What did you get her already?
My power coin?
What?
Before I knew it was... Never mind. I just need to get her something else.
I'm sure you can get something in Tokyo.
Why are we talking about this now?
Rangers, prepare for transport. I suggest you focus. The creature has killed hundreds already. You will need your combined strength to overcome it.
You heard him, people. We need to work as a team.
My Zord... Kitty is still in self-repair mode. I might need a little while.
We'll see you there.
Yeah, catch you all in Japan, folks. Let's kick some giant ugly ass.
We will help Trini speed up repairs. Teleporting the rest of you now.
Goldar reels as he is struck across the face by Rita.
Twice! Twice I have sent you to lead your men into battle, and twice you have retreated like a coward.
The suit could not handle the warrior's new machines. Where did they come from?
They are the ancient weapons the scrolls spoke about. This is getting out of hand. They are getting all the powers that were foretold in the texts. Zordon must have read them too somehow. We need to locate him.
We have tried. Wherever the thief is, he is well hidden from our scanners.
And the humans? Can we not track their movements?
They are using teleportation technology. Tracing it is...
almost impossible.
May I suggest contacting the Emperor now?
Finster's creature is still destroying the Earth City. If the Cretan is true to his word, it will not be as easy to defeat as the suits.
Then let us hope the dog is right.
That dog is General. My monster adapts to damage. I have analyzed the data from the battle suits. The amount of damage they would need to deal to defeat it is almost 3 times as much as their animal robots are capable of.
You're sure?
Quite. Hence why I warned you about unleashing such a beast.
It is just as well that I did. Perhaps this monster will not fail me, as others have, as of late.
Tokyo was feeling the power of the creature, just as promised. It stood over 100 feet tall, a black, almost liquid exterior allowing it to simply absorb every blast, every attack the Japanese military attempt. It moves down a large central street. People cry out and run for their lives as its legless bottom shuffles across the ground, absorbing everything it touches. One of its many tentacles rise up and come crashing down through a massive skyscraper and bring the top of it crashing down to the street below. A massive cloud of smoke and ash rises and envelops everything. The street goes silent. The thing looks up inquisitively as huge strobes of rainbow-colored light appear, form and become the four massive Zords. The pterodactyl takes to the sky with a screech, coming up and around for a strike. The other three bound forward and let out battle cries.
All right. Let's surround it and contain it. Stop it before it does any more damage. Zach, Billy, you two hit it with your ranged weapons. Kim, flank it and strike from behind. And try not to hit any buildings. We are here to stop this thing, not make things worse.
Got it.
Yeah.
Coming in.
Kimberly brings her flying beast around and down, firing her blasters at full power into the being. It roars as it is struck. The Triceratops and Mastodon fire from the ground, the former with its tail, the latter with a blast from its eyes. The Rex Zord roars and moves in. Jason tilts the throttle hard and swings the tail around, striking the monstrosity with it. The group watch in amazement as the smoke clears and the damage they have inflicted is absorbed, the black flesh moving and covering the wounds as though they were never there.
Whoa, that didn't even phase it!
Don't stop! Turn off the heat!
But before they can, the creature's tentacles rise. Jason swings again with the tail of the Tyrannosaurus, but this time, the lashing limb wraps around it, grows, and holds the Zord there. Another whips out and hits the Mastodon, sending it crashing sideways into the Triceratops.
Whoa! Look out! Ah!
A third tentacle rises, keeps extending, growing exponentially, and it's soon high enough in the sky to wrap around the pterodactyl.
Warning, losing altitude.
Guys, I'm going down!
The monster roars as it throws the flying Zord crashing down into a building below.
Kim!
But Jason has his own problems. He moves the controls back and forth trying to free his Zord. Outside, the Tyrannosaurus thrashes. The beast now uses all its strength, lifting the Rex up by its red tail high into the sky and throws it. The Tyrannosaur flies through the sky and comes down, destroying everything it falls upon, turning three entire buildings to rubble and dust.
Warning, system damage. Weapon cannons offline. Outer shell breached.
Everyone, check in!
Mastodon can't take much more of this. I found the self-righting button, though.
Think I still have all my horns.
Kim? Kim! Talk to me!
I'm okay. Still in one piece. Can't say the same for the building I landed on, though. But I may need a few minutes before I can fly again.
How many people just...
Can't think about that now, Billy. Let's change tactics. See if we can lock it down somehow. Keep it in one place.
I have an idea.
Me too. I think...
The two stout Zords right themselves and again move in on the creature. The Mastodon reels back, lets out a trumpeting cry and jets a cold blast of air from its massive trunk.
You need to chill out, buddy!
The monster cries out as its black liquid-like skin begins to ice over and freeze.
All right, keep doing that. I'm not sure how exactly I know to do this, but this should hold him.
Billy presses a few commands on his console. Outside, the Triceratops' horns fly out from its head, extending into huge chains. The horns shoot forward and puncture the thing. Billy puts his Zord's tank-like wheels into reverse. The chains go taut and hold the beast in place.
Yes!
These things are full of surprises.
But the monster is not done yet. It brings up its forward tentacles and lashes out, grabbing the chains and pulling. It seems to be resisting the cold, now in a tug of war with the Triceratops. Billy puts his foot down, going into full reverse. The blue Zord moves back and forth again as it grapples against the monster's weight and strength.
Turning up the cold!
You're enjoying this, aren't you?
But again, the monster seems to resist it, raising up two more tentacles and bringing them crashing down into the chain horns. pulling and ripping the Triceratops' horns from its body, throwing them to the earth with a massive thud.
Damn it!
Billy recoils the horns back into place just in time before they can be used against him.
All right, back to action!
Jason calls out as the T-Rex Zord returns to the battle, charging in and striking the creature with its silver-clawed arms. But again the thing responds, thrashing and sending the Tyrannosaur falling back from a backswing, bringing two more limbs up and smashing them into the black and blue Zords.
Man, we aren't even slowing this thing down!
Back in Hong Kong, the powered-down saber-tooth tiger rests. Now surrounded by a massive military force, helicopters shining spotlights on it as they circle. But they haven't been able to penetrate the Zord yet. Inside, Trini watches this on one monitor, and the Tokyo battle on the other, the POV switching as it moves from the nose cameras of each Zord in the fight.
Man, Kitty, we have to get there now.
Repair progress is only at 88%.
Yeah, well, if we don't, then we're going to get nuked or something. And my friends need me.
May I suggest the crystals?
The crystals?
The formation of the Great Guardian Beast Dai's Yuzin has not been attempted for many years, even before this beast's, Zord's, deactivation. But it would appear the power is needed.
I have no idea what you just said, but sounds useful. Where are these crystals?
They are formed from your power cords. The power will let you know how.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I do.
Trini reaches over and presses to open a line to the other Zords.
Guys, we need to use the crystals in our coins.
Our what?
Think about it. Just think. I did, and now I know how. It's creepy, but yeah.
Oh my god! We can combine these things! That is so cool!
Alpha, I need transport to the battle, now.
Aye aye, Trini. Transporting you now.
Wait, I'm back. What did I miss?
Minutes later, with a flash of yellow light, Trini and the saber-toothed tiger join the fray.
Okay, we're going to need to make some space for this. Retreat to the outskirts of the city.
Got it. See you there.
The monster roars as its foes move away, bounding and flying to as open a space as they can find outside of Tokyo and beginning the sequence.
Okay. Let's hope this thing doesn't take too long. Power up your crystals!
One by one, the teams take out their power coins from their belts and move their hands sidewards away from them. A streak of light of their color follows to form crystals of light.
It worked!
They knew exactly what to do next, their minds in sync with their Zords. They each bring the points of light down and into a perfectly sized slot on their dashboards. They all look up and around them. As the metal begins to whirl and move, the Zords rumble as they begin to break apart. Zack was the first to notice as the head of the Mastodon detaches, flying away with him in it.
Holy shit!
Behind him, the rest of his Zord's body breaks in two, twists, and forms into black and silver arms. The saber-toothed tiger and Triceratops are now on autopilot as they move in parallel to each other. The tiger's body flattening out and both their Zord's tails swinging back over and resting on top of their main bodies. Those bodies then begin to rise, leaving their heads flat to form some kind of boots. The Tyrannosaur flies up into the air, Jason having no control as the legs swing back and form perfect connectors, coming down and slotting into the yellow and blue Zords. Seconds later, the Mastodon arms also rest into place. The Rex stands straight up now with the other three Zords making it into a humanoid form. Finally, the Pterodactyl flies up and around, coming down and swinging its body around into a vertical position. Its wings fold back into the body, as does its head, forming a chest plate that comes down and rests into place on the chest of the humanoid form, just as the T-Rex head drops away to reveal a knight-like face. As the chestplate clicks into place, the horns of the Tyrannosaur swing around to become ears, almost a crown. The five Rangers are all now automatically teleported into a cockpit, which has stations for each of them. The mighty combined Zord is formed.
What is this thing called?
Kittysaurus told me some silly name I can't say.
This thing's like a Megazord.
That'll do.
Yeah, okay, sure. Megazord online! Let's end this thing!
Jason reaches down, and just like his own Zord, he knows exactly what to do. Entering the commands to take to the air, rockets firing from the back of the Megazord as it takes to the sky, flying back into the fight. Meanwhile, the Repulsor continues to use Earth's hacked satellites to watch the battle in real time, or as close to it as they can.
What is that?
It is fine, my queen. They have simply given my monster one target instead of five.
I think we should start thinking of a new plan. Perhaps if I could send fighters as reinforcements.
That would be unwise. The creature may destroy our own ships as well.
Incompetent fool.
I did warn you.
Silence! Hold your tongues, or I will have you both thrown in the brig.
Of course, my queen.
One target, yes. Yes, they can pull out all the surprises they want. We will still prevail.
The Megazord comes down to the earth. Sabretooth and Triceratops beat first with a loud boom. Is now standing across from the rampaging creature again. The monster lets out a mighty roar and moves towards the humanoid robot. The Rangers bring up the fists of the Megazord and move in themselves.
All right, all power to defenses. Zack, punch a hole in that thing.
You got it.
The monster sends its front tentacles flying at the Megazord. It crashes off the chest and head with massive sparks of impact. Zack reels the right arm back, forming the hand into a fist and bringing it down, roundhousing the monster.
That hurt it.
Look out, it's coming back!
Indeed it was, sending its limbs at them again, lashing at them, and then extending the tentacles to wrap the Megazord up in them.
I can't get free! Give me more juice!
That's everything we have!
What if this thing works like our suits do?
Huh?
We think in our suits do it. What if this thing has weapons too?
Like a big sword or something?
Whatever you do, you better do it fast.
Okay. All right, Megazord. We need a weapon now. A sword!
At first, they don't think it has worked. But then a massive silver ornate sword begins to form in the Megazord's right hand, slicing the tentacles and freeing them.
All right!
The team move back to create some space, circling the beast, and then charging. They bring the sword down and slice one of the tentacles clean off. Another tentacle lashes out for them, and that too is cut in half.
Oh yeah. That for sure hurt it.
Let's finish this!
The team move in again, raising the huge, powerful sword high, then bringing it down with a mighty slash. Electricity seems to spark from it as the sword meets the body of the monster and cuts it deep. The teens are beginning to think they need to strike again, but a moment later, the thing's eyes roll up. It falls and crashes to the earth, dead. The sword now lowers to the side of the colossal humanoid form. Its arms resting to the side. They had won. Far below, dots slowly begin to emerge from the wreckage. Humans. The people of Tokyo emerge from where they had been hiding and look up in amazement at the enormous Megazord. That is when the Rangers hear the sound. The sound of cheering. It is growing louder as groups begin to join in with the first to do so. The Megazord turns its head as the group look around to see the people, making sure they see what they are hearing.
They're cheering.
Yeah, you see it. But we should leave before people show up that aren't so grateful.
The crowd continues to yell and cheer as the Megazord's backpack thrusters ignite again, and it takes to the sky. Turning and blasting away, soon nothing more than a gleam of light to the celebrating crowds. An hour later, the team are assembled back in the command center. Their Zords return to their hiding places, and their planet safe again.
Wow! We had no idea the Zords could do that!
Indeed. What is it you call this combined form?
Megazord!
That will take some getting used to. But again, I find myself congratulating you on saving your world.
Do you think that's it?
They won't give up that easy. I'm surprised that reinforcements haven't gotten here yet.
As am I. But we should be grateful for it. And ready if Bandora chooses to strike again.
Right. Now to get yelled at and grounded till next century. Might not be easy for me to get away next time, guys.
Oh, we got to work on the cover story.
Good luck.
Alpha, please aid the Rangers and send them home.
Yes, Zordon!
The group now all move towards the transporter room. As they do, Trini walks over and hands something to Zack.
What's this?
Trust me, your mom will love it. I get them for mine every year.
Zack looks inside the box he has been handed and sees a gemstone of some sort. The kind that would usually be put into jewelry.
Oh no, Trini, I can't.
Yes, you can. I can get another one. I know a guy. Take it, trust me.
Thanks, Trini.
You're welcome.
You had this on you all this time?
In my bag. Forgot I had it.
You're amazing.
Come on, my mom will freak if I'm gone much longer.
Yeah, mine too.
Angel Grove, California, a few minutes later. The front door of Kimberly's house creaks open. Kimberly trying to sneak back in the dead of night. But as soon as the door closes, the lights turn on. Her parents standing with red faces glaring back at her.
Oh, hi. Guess I forgot the time. This sucks.
The bridge of the Repulsor is silent. In the middle of it sits Rita in her command chair, her head in her hands. Goldar approaches.
You might have me executed for saying this, Bandora. But we have failed. We need to call for reinforcements.
Not yet.
Not yet. Our forces are even less than what we began with. Our fuel low, our battlesuits destroyed, and our creations useless. We have nothing else to—
We have one more play. I didn't want to do this, but they have given me no choice.
And what would that be?
To fight fire with fire. Power with power.
Goldar looks as from a pocket in her uniform, Rita produces a golden coin. A coin with a claw upon it. A power coin.
Where did you get that? You told the Emperor that that coin was stolen by Zordon with the others.
Perhaps I did. Perhaps I wanted to make sure I wouldn't be forgotten while our Lord takes the power for himself.
You will die for this.
You will be silent.
Rita stands, now face to face with him.
I am in command here, and I am the one who orders executions. Your fears are unwarranted. Lord Zed rewards success. Nothing else matters. With this, we can succeed. But I do not know. I do not know how to use it. I've tried. We need to find a host who can.
And if it can only be wielded by humans?
Then we shall have to find a human. Won't we? And in the meantime, we will use what we have to continue to attack the planet. Even if we can't beat the warriors, every chip will expand until the earth is covered in cracks. And then our own warrior will shatter it.
The next morning, Zack takes a detour from his usual Saturday hangout and returns to town, to the shop at which he purchased the coin. But when he gets there, it is gone, replaced by a vacant toilet space where it should be.
What the? Hey, excuse me.
Zack walks over to a passerby.
What happened to the shop that used to be here?
Huh? What shop? That place has been empty for a year.
What? It was... But then that means someone created a whole shop just to give me the coin. Zordon and Alpha say they don't know anything about it. So, who?
He decides to forget it and move on. This was a mystery for another day.
Ah, hell. It doesn't matter. Whoever it was, I should thank him. I've saved the Earth twice. And I got an ancient huge elephant robot that connects with four other giant robots to make a mega robot. Bad ass. Certainly beats basketball.
As Zack walks down the street, an old human man stops and looks on after him. The shopkeeper. A smile appearing on his face.
Good luck, Ranger.